host or hearing?
This is live.
This is live. Y'all are live now. Y'all are internet famous from now until we finish streaming.
Right.
And everyone in the background is too. Y'all are Twitch stars now. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to pre-launch tournament Tower Rumble. First up, we have our champions, Wizard Man and Tim.
There we go.
All right, Wizard Man, push it a little bit away from you. Up to your right. Nope, other right. Push it away. Oh, nope.
Oh, no, it's backwards.
It's reversed. Push it that way. There, perfect.
All right.
We are awesome.
Good to go.
Okay. Y'all can do this. So, is he on the other side?
Yeah, I think it's reversed.
Okay. All right, here we go. Wizard Man's choosing. Which army will he choose?
Looks like we got the undead slimes for player one.
I'll jump in here anytime you want. They know you.
Oh, I'm just, I was going to link it to my Facebook, so it's my
people. Sounds good.
Hey, the...
We're going to need to change the title of the stream.
Oh, I did.
Okay. It didn't update yet. And we are go. Starting out early, we got some yellows flying out. Blues being missed there, unfortunately. Missed opportunity. The undead is hammering our dwarves. Dwarves are bagging on their pipes, and the undead are crawling up their lane. Center lane being held strong by Wizard, while Tim is taking the far lanes. This is anybody's match. Looks like your dwarves are doing a hard push down the sides while the center is controlled by the undead. Center very important, but as we all know, if you get two towers, you win the game. So right now, once again, anybody's game. We got the champion coming up as a paralyze has popped off. Tim gets the advantage with the paralyze, one of the most powerful spells in our game. The ballistas are coming out next. Dangerous combo. That's why you have to grab this treasure chest. And is the game turning? I'm seeing a lot of dwarves on the board now. The undead army looks like they survived the double impact of the paralyzed and the ballistas. They are holding them on the 10-yard line, and they are starting their push back. We have the champion coming out for the undead army. Wizard is pushing hard to try and reclaim some land, but the dwarfs are holding strong. The dwarfs are taking the bottom lane strong. What are we going to see happen here in the next few minutes? That's right. We got live tournaments today. Pre-launch tournament for Tower Rumble on Twitch.
Where's Steve?
Yeah, he's gone. We'll miss
That's
him.
Steve, right?
I'm
this
Steve.
Is Steve McCall. I thought you meant Steve Scott.
They're talking about Steve Scott, too.
Yeah, Steve Scott is gone.
Yes, he's at a convention.
So proud of you guys.
Oh, thank you.
This is cool stuff.
It's a shame you weren't here earlier. You could have gotten in on this. $50 gift certificate, man.
It's a little hungover, man.
Oh, I hear you. Oh, another paralyze we just popped off. That's going to turn the tides, I think. Look at the undead army starting to reclaim their land. We have a little bit of damage on the bottom necro army. The dwarf is pushing hard to reclaim that, and one explosion down. This is not the end of the game, though. The undead army are pushing hard on the top and holding the center. As a matter of fact, they're making advances on the center now. Can the undead make a comeback?
Oh, that was a nasty.
Oh, and a nasty explosion just went off.
Undead are susceptible to poison.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think we're about to see a massive turnover. The undead are looking weak on the top, but their timer runs out. Who has killed the most? We got a tower down and victory. Goes to the wizard for the first round, but it's best of three, so this is anybody's game. Best of three, double elimination today. That could have gone either way. Get a good start, rocking the centers, going to hold up that line. Good time to throw out some negatives. The explosions are somewhat wasted on the center at this time because they're only destroying rock. I like to boost mine and neg theirs whenever I see those rocks. Oh, we have a triple yellow just showed up. I would have to say someone got a power up that I missed because those yellows were flying.
Oh, yeah.
We got a speed boost just popped off for the undead. I don't think those yellows are going to be enough. Dwarfs are taking the top, undead are taking the bottom and the center. That center row, as we know, is super important. Center tower looks like it's taking some damage on the dwarf side. And they are busted through. The center is taken by the undead. Will Wizard be able to pull this off
and
get a double victory? He's pushing the bottom. We've seen some amazing comebacks, so you can't count anyone out until the towers are crumbled.
Remember when she was a baby?
I remember she was like that.
You know what scares me?
Remember she started when the hurricane came up?
Oh, yeah. Well, see,
she started walking.
That's it.
The necros may be pushing the bottom hard, but the tower is still hanging in there. The health bar is still pretty healthy. They're starting to chip a little damage on it, but still strong.
Pushing the top too.
Pushing the top as well. The top is starting to get hit. You see chip, chip, chip. Bottom tower 75% down, or 25% down. We have a champion came out on the bottom. Will that champion be able to push back? We're taking chip damage on top as well. Top tower is about halfway down. We have some blues coming out, some explosions. Those explosions you use them for direct damage. And we have a lot of yellows. Once again, spell must have been popped that I missed. So yellows are flying. Ladies and gentlemen, it looks like we lost the top. Great match by both competitors. Tim will have a chance to work his way back up as the real wizard moves on.
That's pretty cool. Lightning fingers.
That's it.
Yes, I noticed you doing this.
Lightning bolt, lightning bolt.
Yeah, this grows. Yeah.
Okay, real wizard moves on. Next tonight, next up is Kyle. I'm blind, and Aaron, it's me. I'm blind, and it's me. Running a tournament, Paul. We're running a tournament. It's live on Twitch. Say hi to everybody. That went really well. Super happy with that. Yeah, man, get him in here. Why not? Ladies and gentlemen, Dave. Dave is the unofficial mascot. We're putting the camera on Dave. Dave hangs out at the Three Alarm Comics in the liquor store and out front, and is buddy to, buddy and friend to all. Dave, the most chill cat you'll ever see.
Yes, he will.
Okay, the game is afoot. We have I'm blind, and
it's me.
Why is it saying Monica now? Me and Val. I think I called the wrong people up. Hold on a second.
Can you just change names?
No, probably not.
We're basically in a straight shot.
Wait.
Here, you just gotta go that way and go back around.
That shouldn't have been next. It should have been. Hold on, gentlemen. Y'all pause it. I called up the next two people wrong.
Somebody got a freebie.
Somebody got a free practice in. Okay, so you go from here. Then we go to these two?
Yeah.
Or do we go to these two? I guess we go to these two next. All right, my apologies.
It's going to be...
Next is going to be Monica and Kyle. I'm blind. I know what I did. I called it before I put in the winner for the last one.
Oh, okay.
Monica is not back, so I'll play for Monica. You win regardless. You get a bye. Yeah.
It's an exhibition game.
Exhibition game.
Look at it like this. If you beat me, you get eternal glory.
What exactly is the eternal glory encompass?
Do we have plan?
Okay, I flipped the horizontal on the camera, so it looks the people are on the right side.
So this is
actually let's do that. Yeah, hang on. Flip the horizontal back there, then we'll change this one.
Yeah, it just makes it easier to call.
Transform.
Oh, you just start pouring.
Horizontal. There we go.
There we go.
All right, it is pouring outside.
It is definitely pouring.
Hope you don't lose internet.
We're off to a fast start here. We got King on the right. We got I'm Blind on the left. Blind's pushing the bottom pretty tough. Starting to push the top as well.
King's got good penetration in the center. Center's always very important to keep.
He's pushing center hard.
Looks like center's been destroyed, but it's not over yet. Quick. You need two towers. He's hanging on to two power-ups there. That turned the tides a little bit. Now we got some serious third lane action.
King's pushing top, Horn bottom. Which one's going to get taken out first?
It's a race. They're both concentrating on different lanes.
Yep.
They're low in hit points on that top. And there it goes. A good match. All right, round two.
Oh, he's cracking his knuckles. Thing's about to get real. And his neck. Oh.
Well, he got lucky with that champion starting on the top lane.
And I got a speed.
And he got a speed boost. Oh, nice single Reaper there. King's still pushing that top lane.
He is. These guys are...
Oh, and he got a stun.
Oh.
And there it went. Top lane is done.
Some people call me the space cowboy. Some people call me the rumbler of love. That's not bad. Some people call me Ryan.
Spell power has been increased.
Right, pushing that center.
That makes all spells more effective. And so there goes the middle tower. Good game.
That was an exhibition, so Kyle still goes on. Monica just lost.
Add the.
Alright.
Or is it a website?
It's an app. It's like $2, I think. All right. Aaron and Jimmy, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, Aaron, it's me and Jimmy Val. We're seeing one of our Twitch champions going up against one of our longtime heroes of the classroom. Fantastic little artist. He is familiar with the Tower Rumble from before it was even called Tower Rumble.
I dabble.
And Val dabbles.
I'm a Twitch champion, so.
That's right. He's a Twitch shop hero. Got stars in his keyboard. Val spends many a night harassing me on Twitch, so y'all know and love him. Yes, his Neo Gold game is strong.
Does that transfer to Tower Rumble?
Yeah, if you win, we'll give you some Neo Gold. I didn't think about that. We should put that on. All right. Look, Jason Payne. What's up, man? I was hoping you'd be in the tournament, Jason. Jason, join us on Twitch.
We fixed it, Shanna. Had some horizontal vertical issues.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we got humans versus dwarves here.
Shayna, glad to have you in chat watching this historic event. Wish you were here. This is intense. You can feel the energy. The game's rumbling, the table's rumbling, the towers are rumbling. Got a bunch of yellows popping up. Val's trying to save his bacon, but his bacon looks like it's getting a little crispy. The dwarves with their mining equipment are wrecking it. We have a champion in the center. Will the champion be enough?
Some very enchanted basic dwarves there.
Isn't it enchanting? Spells are in the air.
There goes the speed.
The speed boost is bad. Oh, bad news for Val.
Oh,
and the
heal.
Top is about to be popped. The heal, is the heal going to be enough? No. Ooh. As the top goes down, the middle's looking pretty crispy, as is the bottom. And there it goes. Will Val be able to rally? Or will he lose to his younger, faster component? No.
Let's put that in perspective. You are
younger. It's because he's got his hat on.
Oh, is he bald?
No.
Not yet.
And here we go, second start, rocking the middle, giving our opponents time to catch their breath. You can see our competitors in the background practicing hard. The true gamers never take a break. Adriana's thinking about tackling one of them. She's our football star. Wave hi to the camera. Hey! They came off a big win last night. There's a lot of dwarves on the table, but I see the humans are taking the top. Dwarves are taking the center and the bottom.
If nobody knew that we were playing a game, that kind of sounds kind of weird.
Well,
a whole bunch of dwarves on the table.
That's true, yeah. It's like college all over again. Oh, there goes the bottom. This is not looking good for our Twitch regular. Jason Payne says, it's buffering. If I was there, I would win a few. Jason, he's been practicing.
Okay, I'll try lowering the bit rate a little bit after this battle.
Shayna's saying, I wish I could play that well. All it takes is practice, Shayna. Oh, that was ugly. Val, you did excellent, though. I was pulling for you.
Oh, thanks.
Good job, AA Ron.
Back to where I feel comfortable. Yeah, not getting wrecked.
Typical.
Going to rumble in the jungle. It's AA Ron, or It Is Me moves on. Which next brings us up to John and Apathy. John and Apathy. This is going to be an exciting match.
They both been practicing during the last couple matches too.
Apathy is on our left, John is on the right, and action and rumbling is in the middle.
All right, it's Slimes versus Slimes.
Not to put any pressure on John, but his mother does teach video game making. So we will all have a good laugh if he does not win. No pressure. And it's on. As our two warriors are slamming jellies against each other. Oh, the humanity. It's ironic because as soon as Monica gets back, we're having toast and jelly. So it's kind of a prequel of things to come. It's probably not going to be as violent, though. But since you all know Monica, it may be. Oh, just missing that double yellow. When is this jelly on jelly? The top went fast. Bottom being controlled by Adriana's jelly. Center is about to be controlled.
It's got a champion
by
out
John's
front.
With a champion and explosion.
One down.
This is intense. And oh, there goes our second. And John with our fastest win of the day. Congratulations. You can do this. I see. Does it have the time?
No, it doesn't have
no,
it.
No, okay. Apathy, you can do this. I know you care. Apathy. It looks like with playing like that, John will not get a John, Dear John letter today. Is there an opposite of a Dear John letter?
Dear Jane?
Dear Jane? No, this is the same. Well, gender-wise. Strong start. Apathy is actually pushing ahead. Look at that. Are you jelly? Oh, we have some skulls popping out there, though, as John reclaims the center. Is pushing back.
Some power sitting and waiting.
Yeah, he's waiting to pop the ugliness. Tories, another Tories has arrived. Kyle has moral backup now as the older brother shows his support. Ladies and gentlemen, are we going to see an upset today? Apathy is pushing hard. Oh my goodness, but John is pushing back. Now we're good.
I think we need another HDMI in card for it. Another camera, a third camera. One day.
Sax Girl is here cheering John on in chat. Yay! His mommy. That's awesome. I always wondered what that would be like. I'm going to have to take a moment and hand it off to Val and Steven. I hope my mom's not watching.
If your phone starts ringing.
If the phone rings, I'm not answering it. This game is getting intense.
Yeah.
Sax Girl is saying, go for two, go for two. Let's go, John. Let's go, John. Apathy is pushing so hard. Look, she's got a champion jelly bears out. And she's about to take the top, and she has, and she's about to take the center. Oh, my God. Apathy has found some carrying, and she is sharing with the tower rumbling and some tumbling.
Mommy's not here to save you today.
Oh, and Val.
Still pushing.
Oh, that's a good counterattack in the center
lane.
That
was an excellent counterattack. That hard push, and the little gummy bears have come back. The gummy worm champion is in the center, too. What does this mean for this tournament? And he's staying in the center. It's all coming down to the bottom lane. And the bottom lane is being pushed hard. It's in the center. We have a very equal battle right now. Explosion just went off. Oh, the humanity.
He's still holding on to two power-ups as well.
It's about to go down. The timer's going to tell who has killed the most people. And victory goes to John. Apathy, that was so close.
Very close.
That was so close. I thought you had that. That's all right. You're still in this. It's double elimination.
I wish I knew what it was like to play that good. Good job, guys.
Excellent job. Woo! All right. Up next, as soon as I can get this together, Rumble, John moves on.
This first bracket down, right?
Yep. First bracket is down. So we go to loser's bracket, and in loser's bracket we have Tim and Monica.
Whenever she gets here.
Monica's not here, which means you get to play me for the bye.
Can we do the old loser bracket? Or do you think she'll be...
Can we skip to the other one? Will that affect anything?
Yeah, you could probably just do it as long as you don't go down the column.
It's Jimmy and Apathy then. Hopefully Monica will get here in time to play against you. Apathy's fingers are warmed up. She's ready to rock this. Here she is. Rock you like a hurricane.
Might have to just quit out and then I go back in. Yeah, just quit that and go back out. There's a little button on the side. It should be above the power-ups. There you go. Just go to exit and two-player.
Setting up the battlefield. I'm going to our chat online to see who's watching in. Shano's cheering for Apathy. Apathy, go, go, go. Go, go, go.
How many people are watching?
Jason is talking smack online saying I could win, but he is not here. Sax is celebrating, and just a GC. Quit bragging, Jason.
All right, here we go.
Here we go. It's on now. Hey, Wade, welcome to chat. We've been missing you, buddy.
Wade.
Oh, quick start with Val opening it up. We've already got a Medusa on the thing. We're going to have a Paralyze. Paralyze can change a game in a heartbeat. It's a hard push for the top, the center. Bottom staying strong because the rock is holding it. Val pops the speed.
The speed first tower,
after that Paralyze is a double killer combo. That's as ugly as it gets, ladies and gentlemen, as the second tower goes down. And we have a new fastest victory of the day. Apathy. Do not let that get to you, though, because that combo is rare. That was an ugly, ugly chain of events that led to that.
Hey, virtual guys.
Hey, virtual. Welcome to the action. And we're off again. They do not waste any time.
Oh, triple Reaper right off the bat.
Reaper, Reaper, Reaper. The dwarfs are pushing hard. The jellies are holding. Jellies are taking the center while the dwarfs push on the top. Bottom is being held by a rock. Slowing down the action.
Oh, he's got a champion spawn.
Got champion spawns versus some double negatives. The champion spawns are ugly. We see them coming out in droves as the mechs are doing their steampunky damage. Can Apathy hold them off? We shall see. She's dropping some negatives, which are definitely going to help. She's dropping some skulls. Will it be enough? She's starting to hold the bottom line. Her top two towers are still healthy. Bottom one is damaged. Scott, would you care to join us? I'm starting to lose my voice.
I'm here.
We got Mr. Scott Hoverman here at Three Alarm Comics, graciously letting us run our tournaments here. Three Alarm Comics, the best comic shop around. Sometimes you want to go where everybody knows your name.
I don't know these people.
And sometimes they're glad that you came. Now, Three Alarm Comics, where the action is. We've got an intense game. Apathy's about to lose the bottom, but she held the tops. Not only did she hold the center, but she's taking the top lane back. If she can push hard on that center lane, she might come back from this. Can she do it, ladies and gentlemen? Oh, it is not looking good in the center. And Val with the stun. We all know what that means. And a rebuild. That's pouring salt in the wound. Salt in the wound. We got some explosions coming in. We got some blues coming up. We got some reds coming up. We have a ballista. Will the ballista be able to push that back?
It's going to be extra DPS.
Apathy is doing a great job pushing, holding that center line right at the baseline. Still has about, was having about half. Oh, now we got some problems in the center. It's being hit and an explosion. Well played, Apathy, but I'm sorry. Val, congratulations. So you.
Good game.
That was a good game.
That first one was extremely lucky for me, though.
All right. Anthony, Tim, you're up. And you're going to play a game against me because Monica's not back.
Push the tablet up a little bit.
Set this up right.
A little more. There you go. Perfect.
Put the loser's bracket.
You sure you don't want to play? I'll show you what to push.
You think you're old? All right, we got humans on humans, both strong and weak to defense. Brian making ground on the bottom lane.
He's trying to push the middle as well.
He's got a champion reserve too ready to go. And he's very buff. And the bottom lane is gone.
Still folks from that middle looks like now.
Yeah, he's got a lot of strong elements through that. They're getting every bonus stacks. So it's worth it to overload. He's on the doorstep, center lane.
Not much health left on that tower, on that center lane.
And there it goes. It's a good game.
Fortunately, you win no matter what.
Wish we had StarCraft announcers.
Oh, yeah. The shoutcasters.
They're so good at what they do.
Brian, quick off the mark in that center lane.
Pretty even on top and bottom.
Yeah, it looks like it's evened up again.
King's pushing that center a little bit still. Center tower is probably about 25% left.
And Brian with the tower upgrade. You didn't need the hit points, but it does give you a ballista support for a little while. And here comes unlimited fireballs on blue. And with spell power increased.
Not looking pretty for the center, but oh, he's pushing back, actually. Oh,
Red's taking a pounding now. And a speed up.
Yeah.
Now is when the tower upgrades would be handy. He's made a comeback in the middle lane. Top lane is still under pressure.
Under pressure.
Oh, and a destroyed champions. That helps.
That's right. The bottom lanes. Can't see the health. So about halfway down.
Bottom lane's made a big push for Red. Oh, and there goes the center too.
So he's going to focus on that bottom now.
Spell power has been increased. Yeah, that means there's probably about a minute left. Oh, and here comes champions from King.
Bottom's down.
Oh, good game. That was a good game.
Look at you. You took out one of my towers. Good game. You still move on in the winner's bracket. Oh, almost lost.
Sorry, I'm a little worried there.
I was a bit. I'm like, yeah, okay, I made one mistake. Okay, I made another mistake.
Sorry about making all the mistakes.
And that knocks Monica out of it.
And those games get intense. It's not a lot of time to strategize. You got to just go on the fly.
Right, going back up to the winner's bracket, we have Wizard Man versus I Am Blind.
Unless it's a clever ruse.
That's right.
If his, you're really playing someone who's blind, you'd be playing.
He's saying I'm blind, but his skills are I'm deaf. Demonic equip, that was good, Val. Because as we know, she looks at chat as much as what, Val?
About as much as Stevie Wonder looks at anything.
That's right.
Looks like we have dwarves versus slimes. What's going
on. Dwarves and slimes? Yeah, you guys are good, man. Nobody likes him anyway, so we'll be okay.
It's his channel, but no one likes him. Everybody who guessed it is a lot better than he is.
Technically, Swaggy sets it all up, so it's really his channel. All right, we got
pretty even start.
Starting out.
Like we had a double center, Reaper there.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Wizard making progress now. Center.
A couple instant kills. And champions coming in. Looks like Wizard's pushing bottom, top, and center, actually.
Yeah. Some double yellows there. Ooh. And extra ballista support now.
Those yellows can change the top of the game.
Oh, yeah. Especially
fast.
Double Reavers in a row. That'll really affect the column. or is blind of the double reapers that changed the tide on the center.
Blind's making a pushback on all three, actually. Oh, blind's...
Oh, there are dwarves everywhere.
Oh, buddy.
Oh, and he's got a speed up, too. That's going to really affect the DPS.
Some double yellows followed by some double reds. Wizard's trying to push back.
Oh, yep, there he's making progress in the center lane. Towers are still relatively healthy.
That's right.
Here comes a triple red. Oof. Oh, and a poison. That's going to help. With spell power increased. The Reaper in the center, that's got him on the doorstep now.
Yeah, these next 20 seconds are going to make a huge difference in this game. It's going to be this.
On another speed up.
Pushing that top tower is pretty close to being down. So is the center and the bottom.
It's a full-on press from the dwarves. Oh, and triple yellow's coming through.
I'm surprised this match is going as long as it has. It's been a back-and-forth battle.
Yeah, Wizards defended really well.
That's right.
Oh, there goes the bottom tower.
The center's getting close to down as well.
And there goes the top.
Yeah, good game, guys.
That was a very good game.
It's good back and forth.
Yeah, you can buy power-ups between games. It's a huge advantage going into the next round.
Yeah, it's going to make a big difference. Let's see.
Hand out the buttons.
All right. Nothing major at the start, looks like. A couple double blues. Double red from Wizard.
Oh, yeah.
Triple blue from Wizard.
All contestants get these Tower Rumble buttons.
Yay!
We also have special buttons for first through third.
First through third. Yeah. Nobody leaves here without a prize.
And the grand prize is $50 and 3 Alarm Comics credit. As well as some art.
Oh, almost double yellow coming out from Wizard, and almost a triple.
Oh, there we
go. And I almost triple another yellow. Oh, triple red coming out.
Oh, here it comes.
Followed by double yellow, followed by double green.
And spawn champions from blind, so it's going to be yellows versus champions.
The fastest fingers in the West.
Those champions are coming fast and loose.
Oh, I forgot my harmonica.
Oh, darn.
Oh, man. Well, tournament's ruined, everybody. Oh, wah, wah, wah,
wah. Everything's better with a harmonica.
I don't think funerals are, but... Pretty good matchup so far.
Yeah.
Pretty steady, even blind's holding on to those activations, power-ups.
Oh, and there goes the top and the center.
He knew I wanted them.
It's a 1-2 punch.
WL's coming out. Let's see who's got this one. Oh, no. Double towers down. I thought it was a time.
Now it's fighting for coins.
All right.
Good job.
Good game, guys. Let's see who's next one.
All right. I wish this thing would stay open. Who wants
that? That's blind.
The liquor store?
It is open.
Yeah.
That's right, Wade.
Oh, I haven't even been watching chat.
I'm blind one?
Yes.
All right, up next, it's A.A. Ron versus John John. This is fun.
This is.
Da 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 da. We got John to the left and A.A. Ron on the right. Strategizing.
Looks like we got...
Left side we have the Jellies.
Jellies versus I didn't see.
Aaron snuck in there. We didn't get to see his army. He's a dwarf.
Slimes versus dwarves.
A bunch of double combos to start out. Right side's focused on that center as well as the bottom as well.
Oh, that's a stun. That's going to stop the progress.
Yep.
Only for a few seconds, though.
Be enough to catch a little bit back up. Right's pushing that center pretty hard, down about half.
Starting to get a little debuffs going. Oh, there's a speed up.
Got that defense on the center, holding it.
You can fire those fireballs without matching, too.
Comes the heal. Here comes the heal.
That's right.
Spell power has been increased.
Those dwarves are pushing hard.
Yeah.
Jellies are making a comeback on the top.
Looks like right side center lane.
Oh,
he's about to take
it. Hammering back.
We got some poison out.
That boy used poison. Poison.
That's Brian with a little bell bib DeVoe. Oh, there goes the top.
Explosions.
So he's really putting some defense up on
the
center.
In the middle too.
Down.
All right, Aaron with his victory. He threw his arms in the air, and John just doesn't care.
That's right. I'd say congratulations, but you beat me earlier, so not today.
John's looking for this second game comeback. Both gentlemen still in the winner's bracket, I do believe.
Yes.
Yes.
And Monica has returned. Monica, you were knocked out of the tournament, unfortunately. You performed admirably.
You won every game, but you got
knocked out.
You
did a good job.
I hate that.
Never mind. Are we going to do some toast soon, baby?
Sure.
Thank you. A toast.
Should have had your camera so you can look to the right. We need to get a dedicated camera just for that. Just strictly for
they see me enough. Those dwarves are pushing hard.
That's right.
Jellies are trying to make a comeback.
Every single lane.
Aaron has a dedicated strategy. So, I got a feeling the tournaments are going to get nastier from here on out.
Yes.
Because people practice.
Oh, yeah.
Wait till we put in those, the additions. What is that?
It's going to get downright ugly.
Yeah. Right side's pushing all center. Every lane. Rough. Center lane goes down.
Center lane's down.
Bottom's taking a beating. And it goes down as
bottom.
Well.
That's all right. John
good
is
game.
Still in
good
it
game.
With double elimination. He can come back. Congratulations to Aaron performing admirably.
Yeah. Shauna says toast. Toast to the competitors.
And if you want to play the beta for yourself, just head over to towerofrumble.com. You can get it for Android and iOS.
All right, and coming up from the losers bracket, clawing their way back up, we have John and Tim. We actually saw a victor come up from the losers bracket last tournament.
Yeah.
Clawed her way back up, and oddly enough, it was Cat Lady with the claws. She won, and then she talks smack for a month.
She took both, the whole.
Yeah, our first and second place winners both had to work today, so they are not in the running. Saturday's a good day for tournaments.
All right, we got humans versus jellies.
Humans versus jellies. I know I've gone up against a few jelly donuts in my day.
Who won?
I won at first, but they came back. They came back in the end.
They won the war.
Guerrilla warfare.
That's why you don't try to assimilate things.
Well, resistance is futile.
Ewan's making good progress.
Triple red
on the outside lanes. He's got unlimited fireballs coming up.
Tim's pushing hard. Oh, there's a stun though. That's a good counter. Right. This is a pretty mixed game right now.
Yeah.
Jellies are starting to reclaim the center and the top.
Good defense.
Humans pushing hard on the bottom. Champion working it on the bottom row.
And Jellies have made a huge comeback down the center lane.
Jellies take that center. This could be a completely different game. Center row is key. Though it does not decide a victor, it is very ominous.
It's dropping.
It affects your direct damage.
That's right. It's like center's about to go down left. They can push some defense down in the center.
Jellies take the center.
Pretty even on top and the bottom.
Humans are pushing hard. Can they take one or the other?
Spell power's up. The
jellies are going to the top.
Jellies are making a huge pass.
Very.
Humans on the bottom.
Oh, and there it goes.
Down.
Good game.
John pushing hard to get back up into the winner's bracket. Of course, make sure to wash those fingers before touching our tablets after eating the jam. The real wizard being oddly disturbing.
Oh, the poison against the slimes. It's got an unlimited fireballs coming up, though.
Oh, look. Jellies are in a jam. The humans are pushing hard. Champions are grinding them. Fee-fi-fo-fum, they smell the blood of a jellymon.
I think Jellies making a good comeback on the bottom and the top, actually. Pushing back slowly.
They push back. Humans are pushing back. This is a very even match.
Oh, and he's
just
got
had
blisters.
Ballistas go off and healing. Mm. And increased spell power has just been lifted. Somehow the humans are still holding strong. We just had a jelly champion went down faster than I thought it would. This is anybody's game. John's flying his fingers, but the humans are rocking. They call him Tim.
Oh, and there comes the
jelly just ran down the center.
Right down the center.
These spells are getting stronger and stronger as time goes by. Did we just have an explosion?
Yeah, a fireball hit an amplify rune.
Oh, my God. I did not even see that
amplify
coming.
Amplify runes amplify whatever spell in all directions. That was a good comeback by the humans in the middle, though.
The middle looked like it was going to be taken by jellies.
We still oddly have a lot of healthy towers out there right now.
This is a very,
this could go either way. And with the spell's power up as high as it is, it can swing left and right in a second. One poison out there can wipe out an entire row in no time now.
Jelly's making pushes on top and center. Humans making. Humans pushing the bottom.
Doom's been cleared.
Jelly's looks like they're about to take the center.
The top of the board. We're about to have some explosions. And oh, that paralyze stun. Almost seals the deal. Stun is one of the nastiest spells in the game.
Oh, and there goes the top tower. Yep.
Looks like the center's going to...
Oh. Center. And humans, look, can the humans push
are making
back?
A push from center and
they're
bottom.
Pushing a hard center, and they have the bottom.
Push it.
Oh, the human manatee.
That was a very good game.
Oh,
to see who's going to end
it.
Oh,
one of the
wow.
Games
good job, guys.
That was intense.
Who won that one?
That was John.
Right side.
Yes.
I don't know these guys' names. Bar yet.
Okay, next up we have the real wizard man versus Val. The wizard versus the infamous Val. There can only be one. We call him Juan Valdez. He brings us caffeine. Monica is rocking the toast. We can all smell it. Can you smell what the Monica is cooking?
Yeah, it's perfect.
We should do like a little marker on the dry erase on the table next time.
Yeah. And then just I was thinking about bringing some post-its, but I forgot them.
Yeah. Have a seat. You can moderate with us while you play with the Power Rangers.
All right, we got dwarves versus slimes.
Dwarves versus slimes.
The undead skin.
Both being very popular today. We've seen quite a few undead. Monica handing out the toast in the background. Passing it off to A.A. Ron.
It's like
passing
Rumble.
It off to John.
The Tower Rumble
John needs
tradition.
A spoon. Can Monica handle the spoon challenge?
What's burning?
Monica, do you have a spoon or a fork or a knife? Oh, and she's throwing it. We pushed her too far. We got a good start. The undead are rocking the bottom.
Oh, and we got a champion spawn for the dwarves.
Scott stepped in to save some toast.
I am the Toastmaster.
He is the Toastmaster. Center lane is seeing an upset.
Taking advantage of that amplify rune.
Can the undead beat our dwarves? We have a champion in the center dwarf. So many spells flying, he went down somehow. Death, death everywhere.
That center lane had some casualties.
This is bloodier than the opening season of The Walking Dead. Death,
oh, here comes the yellows.
Death taking over the top and the center, bottom being held by dwarfs, actually being pushed further. Yellows flying out everywhere. We got triples flying off.
Oh, and those fireballs are going to be nasty on that center column.
That center column looks like it is not long for this world. And in 3, 2, 1, explosion. Oh. That was ugly. Did he save it?
No, no. I went through.
All right. Center lane is lost to the crawling dead. The bottom lane is being held. Top lane is looking pretty rough. About halfway down on hit points. Dwarf's pushing back to the center.
That one dwarf is holding off the line from those champions, but he just fell.
Those champions are at a snail's pace.
They are debuffed.
They We're looking for a dwarf to come out and champion. And here he is, the bravest dwarf in history, ladies and gentlemen, with the healing plopped on him. And the undead champions are pushing through. They may be slow, but they are super tough. Dead flesh is hard to...
Two triples in a row. But the undead, or the unlimited fireballs are coming. Oh, and there goes
the top. That which was dead could not be killed.
Our Balamogulus.
Yes, we are nerds.
All right. Oh, it's starting off the catapults.
And a speed.
And a countered heal. With an upgrade tower.
Wow. Dwarfs are coming back with a vengeance in this one. They're ripping through cold flesh like it were paper. Someone told them they had haggis if they win. Get the ale and scotch eggs ready. The undead are having none of it, though, as they're pushing back on the bottom and top. They're now holding the line. Can they take an advantage, though? We see a champion on the top row pushing through some dwarfs, but the dwarfs are so buff they ate through them.
Oh, here comes a speed up for the undead.
Oh, we are seeing the quick and the dead, ladies and gentlemen. Not a great movie, but an excellent play in Tower Rumble. I tried to get her to play. She's the cutest thing in the store. Yeah, dwarf's taking the center line, but the undead on the top and the bottom. Bottom has a champion dwarf coming out, throwing lightning from its axes, trying to make an impression on the dead. And it falls, but another champion takes its place. We just had our towers rebuilt on... Balhaza's side, but not enough. Bottom. He lost the bottom. Can he make a comeback, ladies and gentlemen? He has another champion coming out on the top. He's flinging blues to the left and right. He's looking for his negatives. Not a bad strategy, but it will it be enough?
Starting to chip away on that center
tower.
The
real wizard is casting spells like a real wizard, and it's getting ugly. Spell power up. It's anybody's game. The top is going to decide it. Val is about halfway down, but if he can push it back, he might come away with the victory. And it is not looking good for our chat regular as the undead hit away at the last little bit, and we have our explosion. Man, that was a close game.
Good game.
I'd like to take this time to thank Three Alarm Comics for hosting us. We always have a great time at this wonderful comic book shop. Make sure to check us out. We'll be dropping a link so you can get in on the fun.
And you can follow them on their Twitch account as well.
Wizard Man crawling his way back up. We go back to the winner's bracket to have a competition between Kyle and It's Me, both undefeated. Ladies and gentlemen, we are getting down to the nitty and the gritty. The winners shall be decided in the next few games. John and Wizard Man, next y'all will be fighting for a place. Y'all be guaranteed at least third, whichever one of y'all wins this. You get enough victories, you'll be back up to first.
All right, it's dwarf on dwarf.
Would you like some toast? She would like some toast.
next door to find
It's looking pretty even.
Yeah, we are going to see nothing but excellent matches here on out.
Ballistic support from the blue, that's going to help.
Our top competitors are now competing. These are where legends are made, ladies and gentlemen.
Playing for that $50 and 3-alarm credit.
The winner will also be receiving artwork, original artwork from the game of whatever race they decide that helped them the best. And I'll be matting that form and presenting it to them at a later date.
Blue's making a lot of progress in the top two rows. Oh, there goes the top row.
And the bottom. What was that explosion? Did a rune go off that I missed?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, it was a rune. Oh, that was not a base.
Red's making a comeback on the bottom row.
Major comeback.
That speed up. It's coming from blue. Oh, and there goes the second. Good. That was a good victory for
Excellent.
Blue.
Excellent.
Jason may have to unfriend Val.
What did I miss?
Oh, starting off with a catapult attack. But ballista support is the answer. The power-ups are flying.
I'm blind as a fierce competitor coming from our left side. Aaron is having none of it, though. He's pushing back hard. Dwarfs have been very popular today. The winner would like to go out and celebrate. Unfortunately, they will not be allowed to because they are, in fact, minors. Little dwarf humor there.
Did I miss anything good?
Yeah, it's a good battle. Yeah, the dwarfs are just eating each other up.
So who's winning?
Right now, these two are, I think, almost guaranteed a place.
Looks like Red's making a big comeback on the top.
Yep.
And center.
Aaron is pushing hard.
Oh, and the bottom.
Showing him that he is a champion, and he will not be denied his third battle.
As the troops are enchanted, they get bigger, so you can kind of tell where the buffs are going.
Mm-hmm. I Am Blind had a champion held his center.
Oh, and the bottom's gone, and the top's gone.
And the top.
Good game.
Yeah, Butter and Delice down there.
They're going into our third round. Ladies and gentlemen, this one will decide it. Who goes on for medals? Isn't it weird how the toast just became a thing, but it's such a good thing.
Make that part of the advertising.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Scott Hoverman walking by with his toast. Our host. Our host with the toast. It's supposed to be Darth Vader.
It's the. I can see it. Oh, it says Star Wars on that side.
Oh, it says supposed to be Star Wars.
I didn't know either.
Huh? You didn't catch that? Did you see the toaster? It's a Darth Vader head. Isn't that cool? All right. Dwarfs to the left of me. Dwarfs to the right. Cannons all around.
Over here.
They are popping spells like crazy. They both want this bad, and you can tell. The mayhem's going back and forth, ladies and gentlemen. We do not have anyone clearly in charge, but we did have a stun go off. And we've seen stuns change games before. Kyle is making a comeback, though. He did not let that stun slow him down. That up bunch. We just saw a triple negative go off. And it is definitely hurting. Hey, Aaron is taking the top. Kyle is holding the middle. And he's trying to push back on the bottom. We see a lot of blues going off. Slight pause from Aaron as his spells are not working out for him at the moment. He's holding on and decided to throw one back rather than wait. When you get that nasty feeling, you need the angel healing. And that's exactly what he got. We see a champion on the bottom. Is that champion going to be able to eat up? We lose one on the top. It's coming down to the middle and bottom row. And ladies and gentlemen, our two champions have decided it. And Aaron flies back in victory. Excellent match. I would have hated to have battled either one of them.
All right. Would you like apple or grape jelly?
Mr. King. Huh? No, I'm good. I'm on a health kick.
You want butter? Toast?
Oh, you're not even talking to me. I love you too, Monica. All right. Aaron goes into the top three. He's guaranteed a medal. And in the loser's bracket.
I'm going to just a little to the left. There you go.
We have John and Wizard Man. They will be competing against each other, and then whoever wins that will be competing against Kyle, the destroyer of hopes and dreams. Kyle the Blind. He's like Zaito Ichi, but Caucasian. Do y'all even know who Zaito Ichi is? He's the blind sword samurai. They've made like a billion movies in Japan about him. They're all awesome. Yeah. Saito Ichi, watch it. Kurosawa is the man. It says Jeepers Creepers now. That one says Star Wars. You know Monica licks all of those before she hands them out. I'm just kidding.
Anybody else
protect? Hey, we got slimes on slimes.
Slimes on slimes.
Sounds really nasty if you ask me.
Zip, zap, and do pop.
Did we put the mature warning on this stream?
Yeah. And the center slimes are pushing hard. The real wizard feels like he can take that center. But John's not having any of it. He's throwing some spells out fast.
He's got ballistas up.
Ballista. The powers of the ballista is undeniable. Those oversized arrows are hitting home. Yes, they're bolts. And they are eating up your top row, real wizard. Wadabadabada.
Real wizard.
John, crush him. I mean, I don't care who wins.
A little
commentator
bias from...
real wizard pushing back as John's holding the top, center, and the bottom. Explosions going off everywhere. They are wasting no time popping their spells as soon as they get them.
Here comes champion spawns from the undead.
Yep, undead champions are nasty.
Here come the Frankensteins.
Jaharl jumping in with great movies on chat. He's familiar with the Kurosawa stuff.
Oh, the double reaper of that middle row took down all the champions.
Anybody like any more toast?
People always want more toast, Monica. There's never been a time when, like, it's okay to stop making toast. Oh, you bid out everything but the Star Wars. And she's the real winner today. little gummy bears. Gummy bears everywhere trying to take over the jelly. Yes. Foul and malicious, hating this fictitious. Gummy bears bouncing here and there and everywhere. Casting spells that are beyond compare. They are the gummy bears.
Oh, there's the bottom for the bears.
The bears.
The bears.
Bears pushing through. Can the undead make a comeback? Don't call it a comeback. They've been buried for years. Oh.
Time's
and the timer's running out. This is looking ugly. And John.
Wins it with one tower.
Oh, wizard, I was pulling for you.
No, you weren't. I'm not deaf. I'm like a blind person over
here. Well, now I ate it. Star Wars.
Oh, he starts off with unlimited fireballs and chants.
I know if any of the places by here have a bathroom.
These work.
Oh, let's head out.
It says it, but it's not.
Oh, this is a massive press from the
undead. Oh, my God. Real wizards coming back.
There are
fierce.
Yellows everywhere.
Did you bring some?
Yes. Monica brought some perler art to give away today. We are the champions. We sacrifice our blood. They're dead everywhere. Dead's taking the top. Dead's taking the middle. Dead is
every parlor but mine.
Pushing in the middle. We gave yours away.
This is a travesty.
Shayna got yours.
What?
Your rocket?
Oh, no.
She won that.
No,
remember?
My mod one.
Oh, you didn't bring his mod one?
She has a whole stack over there.
My God.
Oh, there comes the second round of champions from blue.
The wizard's trying to take the top, but he's losing the bottom and the center.
Yeah. So take your pick.
Oh, you put some of the ones with the earrooms in it.
Yes. Oh, man, this is getting ugly.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to see explosions soon. I don't know who I'd rather be right now because we have the top is about taken. But the jellies are strong in the center and the bottom. This could be anyone's match, ladies and gentlemen. It's too close to call. I think we're about to lose the top, though. After that, the center is going to decide it. If John can take the center, he's got a real chance of winning this. And with three yellows,
oh, yeah.
Followed by three more yellows, Real Wizard better make something happen real quick. And
oh,
he did not. The bottom one's going to decide it.
Ew.
And it's gone.
Sniped with the fireballs. Good game.
Excellent game. Well, like I said, ladies and gentlemen, these are the top, the best of the best we're seeing now. All right, John won that.
So we're going to do loser's bracket and then
yep.
Final winners.
All right, Kyle, I'm blind, and John. Yep, y'all are both down one. Whoever wins this jumps back up to the winner's bracket, and you're going to go up against Aaron, who has not lost yet. So. Y'all are looking for a string of victories to get the gold. How are we going to figure out third? I guess these.
That'd be a third and fourth play, I guess. Or.
I guess those two, and then whoever wins a loser's bracket will
yeah.
go up. So it's going to be one of. We have our top three right now.
Okay.
Whoever loses this will be third.
correct.
All right, we have dwarves on slimes.
We have nothing but champions playing now, ladies and gentlemen. Everyone still in the running is going to win a medal.
Oh, my goodness. The deciding factor.
This is it. This has been awesome. I feel like I've been reborn through these competitors. No, but we got good prize. Actually, you're going to win $50 first place. You can buy whatever you want in here. Great gift certificate from 3 Alarm Comics. So they could be the prizes. Some of them are pretty old.
This one says 2010.
Yeah, that one's not that old.
I'm feeling the Navy SEAL ones.
Slimes are really pressing, especially on the bottom.
John's pressing Iron well. Blind hard. We're going to have to see some kind of cool spell combination or... And he's taking the top back. The
top's coming up.
That double yellow helped him.
Yes, and another double yellow.
Oh,
Skeletons.
Start taking damage up at the top there.
Double negative. I love the reds. They're my personal favorites. And we have a double green from John John.
And champion spawn.
Oh.
Coming from blue. This is going to get real.
Ugly champion spawn. Look at all of that.
But the
championness. The poison's going to be hurting them.
Oh,
we've lost
the
bottom. The jellies have gone through. John pushing through the bottom.
Like center's about to get taken as well.
Center is about to explode. We have a champion. Will that champion be enough to push back the jelly?
He's got him out of danger. Could really use an upgrade tower.
One dwarf buffer. Yep, that heal needs to be seen.
One snipe's going to do it.
All it's going to take is that yellow, and that's what we saw come in. Good first round. Shana says, yeah, I love the rocket. Val.
Oh, thanks, Shana. Put a lot of time and blood, sweat, and tears into that.
Yeah, we had to get creative to burn it.
And then Jason knocked it off the counter.
He sure did.
But hey.
Right off the counter. You got a rock holding up the bottom. They are... John John took the first round, I believe.
Yes.
And we've got our...
We've got a stun.
Stun.
But Ballista's to counter.
Stun and Ballista's. This is interesting.
That changed. The jellies were pushing forward to that stun.
They were. That stun hurt so bad. But the Ballista's are still going after the stun wears off. The dwarfs are making a heck of a comeback. It'd be glorious to see this go to a third round for the second season. John's pushing back. John wants that second round victory. He does not want to tempt fate.
Oh, there's a stun.
Ooh.
Kyle, I am blind, has hit with a stun, and he's going crazy. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. His dwarfs aren't alone in his time of need. And he's rumbling and tumbling and crushing the jellies.
You married him.
I know, right?
She's happy.
What?
She's
there's a question mark at the end.
She's the happiest middle-aged woman in this whole building. And since we're in a comic shop, she's also the only one.
Oh, there goes the top tower. Dwarves are on full press right now.
Oh.
Four champions.
That's a nice counter. Humanity.
Good job.
And he's got a champion slime out.
Can those slimes make a miracle comeback? That answer and more to come after these messages. Are you feeling lonely? Has the internet got you down? Does Facebook just not live up to the bookiness or the faciness? Well, join our chat and we'll keep you company.
Oh.
As the center explodes. And we go into the dreaded third round. It's weird.
I just envision the announcer from Mario Tennis going, match point.
You should have said that. That would have been funny.
I guess some younger people here, they might not get it, so I had to...
That's true.
Had to find it.
We had to leave off the GoldenEye references. All right. This decides it. Both of them battling on this coolest of stages.
There's a stun from the dwarves.
Oh, the dwarves are making an early push.
But
we did not see
counter.
This coming. John was showing off his game-making breeding and doing rocking it. But Kyle, who's trained with the legendary Tories, has pushed hard. The jellies are making a comeback now. It is once again anyone's game. Very evenly matched. We got a tower upgrade on the bottom. And I think I see ballistas going off. That was weird.
The rain's
coming in. Yeah, the rain's coming in at these end times.
Oh, it was a massive Reaper on the Amplify Room, but the Paralyzed negated it.
The Reigns of Castamere here. Somebody's about to get some bad news.
The dwarves are taking the top.
Slime's
jellies
taking the
are
middle.
Taking the center. And the bottom is just right.
This is a back and forth match right here. This is
yes.
good.
Yeah.
What's that?
This is what I'm going to buy. If
Donald,
I win.
You're going to buy Donald Trump.
I can buy and sell you.
That's right. We Aaron with his Trump card.
I'm also gonna,
we've got a double yellow just came out. Is it going to do it?
Without a
the rain, the storm is setting in as this so important rumble is going on. The center is about to be lost, ladies and gentlemen. John is pushing hard.
Oh, there goes the middle.
The middle's down. Is he going to be able to hold the bottom, or is this going to be it?
The weather's going crazy.
The rain has set in. As the bottom is lost, and this epic victory of the ages comes to a conclusion as John moves on.
Good match.
Good game, guys. That was good.
That was good.
The matches do get better as it goes on.
Yeah. Next time we play, everybody's going to be awesome. Just mark my words. And be like, this will not stand.
Oh, yeah, next tournament, I'm not even competing. I'm just commentating.
All right.
I'm going to work on my speed talking. Oh, we got to center down in the middle. We got a double combo, a triple combo.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Aaron is going up against John for the winners, and Aaron is coming in undefeated, which means John is going to have to put the smack down twice.
Oh
my goodness.
Can he do it? Yes, he can. Will he do it? We don't know.
That's all up to him. His fingers. And the game
was. Da-da-da-da. Da-da. I got to learn how to play down the harmonica. Final countdown.
We got dwarves versus slimes again.
The more intense it gets, the more they're rumbling the table.
Yeah. So intense.
The more violent the weather gets outside.
It is. The weather is insane here right now.
Thor is picking favorites here.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's triple
the
yellow.
Thunder God is watching.
I think it's going to be a hurricane. Like
there are dwarves pressing everywhere.
Dwarves all over the place. That's amazing. The jellies are holding them at the line. They're keeping their towers healthy, but how long can they? With dwarves everywhere. I have to say, this many dwarves would even make Cinderella uncomfortable. Don't correct me on film. I said what I said.
He's we'll the commentator. He controls everything.
More like the wrong commentator.
As soon as I said it, I was like, there are too many smart alecks here for that to go unnoticed. The jellies are making a hard push in the center. Who saw that coming?
Not me.
Aaron, not only a champion, but oh, we did not see that bottom.
Double
John snuck in
room.
There.
Oh,
Oh my God. Is Aaron going to taste his first defeat?
Oh, I mean, this is just the first round.
That's right. He's got one more. One more round. Give me just one more round. Double red coming up. Double negative. Some greens coming up. Some triple blues coming up.
Oh, and there goes the top, so it's down top, to the bottom.
And he just got a speed. This looks bad for the bottom.
Oh, there
and
it goes.
And that is the first round game. Oh. Aaron's feeling the pressure.
That's right.
Aaron looks like he's about to jump over the table and attack his opponent.
Now you know how it felt all after.
You know what's funny? You know that guy Francis that played Magic and flipped the table? Yeah. He actually retweeted our cast one day. It was awesome. I would love to get him on the show.
We have to have like equipment.
I watched his video.
Yeah, he's hilarious.
You'd have to have an iPad to make a break.
Yeah.
Yeah, that dude, he's cool. I like that dude. Shout out to that dude.
Oh, triple
reds. Triple
reds.
I love seeing those reds up
and
close.
And a pair of eyes.
They are holding on to their spells, being more conservative now.
And a poison.
Poison.
I remember a Pokemon that he like bought a bunch of merchandise.
We have a champion eating up the bottom row. John did some double buffs. He's got a jelly pushing out that champion.
Oh, you got rid of those champions with that destroy.
With the bears. He's holding on to his heels for a rainy day. And let me tell you, it's storming outside.
Spell powers. Oh, there goes the top row.
That spell just got ruined.
Why do we laugh? We just enable him.
That's right.
Yeah.
Feed me.
Couple of yellows. We got a champion on the bottom slapping his way through on a dwarf champion.
He's earning his keep there.
Yep.
And he's getting healed.
And ladies and gentlemen, we have a champion kill.
He bought him a lot of time. A
lot of time.
Yeah.
Oh, this is getting ugly. He's holding the end.
He is not happy about losing that first round.
Not at all. Aaron is raging.
Oh, there's a triple reaper there with the amplify rune.
Triple reaper's nasty. We got the hand. He's making his dwarfs talk to the jelly hand. Talk to the hand. Talk to the hand. Talk to the... Oh, he talked to it. It's dead. The bears retook the center.
He's really going to push back.
There's death everywhere as the bears run up.
The
dwarves are pushing the bottom. Fireballs are going off everywhere. Oh, these towers are not looking healthy. Somebody needs to heal or kill because it is not lasting long for John. Oh, he's got a double yellow. Is that going
to
be enough? Oh, my God. This is so close. He just did that. He brings the yellows. He brings the yellows to the party. He just destroyed in the center. Oh, my God. John's tower is almost dead, but Aaron's is being hit with jelly. He is in quite a jam.
Oh, my God.
What is going to happen here, ladies and gentlemen?
I know what's going to happen.
That's going to be another tiebreaker.
And the tiebreaker is going to stop. And John's mom is in chat. Oh, it wasn't enough as Aaron takes a victory.
Three kills was the only thing that separated
three
it.
Kills.
Three
best kills. This was the best match of the day. Best match of the day.
Man,
all right,
so
it's not
good.
Over.
Not over
they
yet.
Both have a victory. This is anyone's heard of.
Next winner
Aaron
wins.
Is feeling it. Look at the sweat beating off of his his forehead.
His muscles are ripping.
John is John's as cool as a cucumber.
I'm having a heart attack, dude.
Someone needs to help.
Sax Girl is saying no.
Just for legal reasons, he is not having a heart attack. Not happening.
Here comes the speed.
John did a hard push.
Everywhere.
John might be able to do this. Those hands are slapping everywhere. The wombs and the hands. all over the place. The dwarves are sneaking down the center. He just got a stun. Aaron is pushing back hard. That stun hurts. Will he be able to overcome the stun? Both of these people are being ultra conservative with their spells. This may be why they're champions. You got to know when to hold them, know when to throw them, know when to walk away, and know when to run.
Man, Aaron can throw down one of his champions and he'd be doing all right.
Wizard, what are you doing over here?
What do you mean, what am I doing over here?
Pay no attention to the man behind the curtains.
You can pay attention if you want.
Throwing out the reds. Oh my god, John took the bottom. Oh, the humanity. This would be a great time to interview Aaron and see how he's feeling.
He's not taking interviews.
You want some more toast?
I would love toast. We have toast.
No, you're eating healthy.
Anybody like toast?
No.
Nah, I'm good.
Want some more? I was putting those yellows to good effect.
Yeah, that center dwarves. Line is about lost, though, to dwarves. What is going to happen? We still have a healthy tower because they are not getting through. They're barely being held off. Did you see that angling of the death? That was awesome. Very nice. By John. That takes a master flinger to do that. These jellies are coming out. Oh, Aaron's pushing hard. And the stun. The stun is going to change things. We're going to see a massive turnaround here. The center row is being reclaimed. The top row is being held by a hand. And Aaron dropped a healing spell. That healing spell is definitely going to slow down the push. We got some greens coming out. Nullifying here, nullifying there. That's right. John gets more yellows than any competitor I've ever seen.
It's ridiculous.
He brings it. Oh, and that center is gone.
It's once again down to the top. He's
pushing hard on the top, too.
Yeah, he can take that top, and that's all he needs.
Oh, it's like single combat almost up there.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Where is it? It is going to come down to it. Look, it's an open field. Jelly, run.
Who wins?
It's a draw!
Yeah, we'll do another round.
Wow. Nobody wins this one. This goes on.
Okay.
That's insane. That is insane. All right. Good luck. Y'all are exactly where you started before that round. I'm starting to feel it. I'm getting the vapors. It's a southern thing. Can y'all hear that thunder and lightning?
It's pouring outside.
It is like... I'm waiting for the arc to come by.
The weather is...
All right, here we go. The dwarfs and the jellies. Dwarfs and the jellies. Dwarfs and the jellies.
In a couple of days, you might
And the stun. The stun has made this an interesting game right off the bat as the dwarfs are pushing through hard. Just as T says, the puns, King, just wow. Jelly's taking the center, dwarf's taking the bottom, and possibly the top. We have two champions slamming each other. We have the lightning versus the jelly hand. That center lane is super important, though. Oh, and the stun. He'll be able to push back that center lane. John almost had it. John just lost the bottom. We did not even see that coming. And a man in the back said, everyone attack. We've got those yellows coming out. John is pushing back hard. A lot of green out there. Aaron's sitting pretty, though, with one tower destroyed.
Pushing that center.
Oh, that stun, yeah.
That stun worked a number. You see the bonuses coming.
You gotta speed up the counter.
Will the speed be enough?
This toast is amazing.
I tell you, the toast is great. Mm-hmm. Toast is life. John's not getting the yellows he's looking for. That's right. Everybody leaves happy. We gotta take an Instagram picture with everybody. There's dwarfs everywhere.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
And spell power's been increased.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, we got two champions fighting on that top, and that center is almost gone. And the speed up. I feel like we're about to go to a second round. And the yellows
again. Here it comes.
And he just ran for the center. If he can take the top, he may push back and get it done. Oh my God.
It's going to be close again.
Did he just heal his towers?
Yeah,
that was
the tower upgrade.
Oh my, he's getting the perfect hand.
Yeah. Oh, it's a champion.
Oh, that champion just said nope.
Nope.jpg.
Dang it, Slappy.
Slappy Joe.
And the dwarves are back.
Look who's back. Back again. Dwarves are back. Back again.
Oh, there goes the tower.
And tell a friend.
What a match.
First round goes to Aaron. John fighting like a champ, though.
Oh, that was it. That was the tiebreaker from the other one.
So. Oh, gotcha. That's it. That was the tiebreaker.
That was a tiebreaker. He wins money that he can only spend here.
Wait, what? That's so awesome.
Is that the final?
I think that was the final.
Yeah, he would have had to win four times in a row. Yeah. To take everything.
So that leaves us first place, Aaron, which will be getting the gold.
Sweet.
Second place is John. And third place is Kyle.
Yay.
Y'all come on up. We're going to do the award ceremony in front of the camera.
We switched to big.
We have a little step stool.
I'll let you get yourself out.
We need to get little step stools like the Olympics.
You know, like Mario Kart?
You want to do it closer to this with the microphone?
Yes.
Aaron posing like a champion.
We're going to do silver first. You never won anything before. Oh, wait, I was saying silver first. We're going to do bronze first.
Bronze.
All right, Kyle.
I'm not going to pin this on you because I'll probably accidentally stab you, so I'll present it to you. You want to get a picture, too?
You're taking your phone?
Yeah, and Monica and Steven.
Do I have some victory toast?
You can have some victory toast.
Victory toast to you.
The victorious toast to the land.
Look over here, guys.
Of course, it's Star Wars.
All right,
congratulations.
Yay!
Yeah, congratulations.
And our silver. Silver also gets to pick a pearler out. Monica will show you the pearler. You wanna just hand me one for right now, then we'll let him pick one later for the picture. Yeah, you'll get to choose which one you get.
Oh, the Mayan bomb.
Actually, that bomb. Want
to take a picture?
I saw she her first. He's still looking at Monica. All right.
Okay. All right, congratulations. Yay! And the gold. Who also gets a pearler, the gift certificate, which is in my briefcase. Monica. Monica, where's my briefcase?
Over behind Val.
Can I just have the briefcase?
No. And you will also be getting a piece of original art of your choosing from the Army.
Yay.
If you want. And I'll get that matted for you and get that to you so it's real nice. And hopefully within a year it's going to be worth a ton of money because the game's going to take off so much. This represent this. Wait, hold them out so they can see them.
Monica first. You beat me, so I hate you.
All right,
you.
Let's get a group shot. Come on, guys, everybody. Steven, come on out here, man.
Yeah, take a picture.
All right. Val, come on. All right. Get over here. The less tall in front.
The tallest in the front?
Yeah, block everybody.
You see everybody?
All righty, see you later.
Wait a second, right. Scott, you should get in this too. Come on in, man. You got it, Monica? You got one? Alright.
Alright.
Y'all were awesome. So which one do you want? Which race?
Which race do you want?
Do you want the jellies? Do you want dwarves?
Oh, do you have any of the gummy bear one?
I got gummy bear. You want the gummy bear? You'll get an original gummy bear.
It's
coming
funny
your way, buddy.
Wolf saw my favorite.
You got it. Well, thanks everybody for joining. Don't
yeah,
forget your
great.
Buttons. Everybody gets a button. We're going to be doing more of these. I'll let y'all know when.
Cool.
We have to launch a
couple.
Yeah, that's how
yeah,
we
have to
launch
so
people get used to it. And
yeah, do a bigger prize too.
And thanks for joining us, everybody online. I'm thinking what I'm going to do and break it down here because storm's getting crazy bad. When I get things set up tonight, then we'll start doing our raffle giveaways. And if the storm gets too bad, we'll do them tomorrow, okay? But we're going to shoot for late tonight.
Oh, yeah, and they've got some other perler art that you can choose from there. We got the perler art.
You did really good for just learning how to play today.
All right, thanks for tuning in, everybody. We'll see you later tonight.